Welcome to this .NET MAUI DataForm control tutorial. With the floating label layout feature in the Syncfusion .NET MAUI DataForm control, you can make labels remain visible within the input field when focused. You can also customize with leading icons to indicate input types and trailing icons for actions like toggling password visibility. In this video, I'll show you how to enable a floating label layout, add icons at the beginning and end of the label, display helper text that provide information for filling out the input field, and customize the appearance of the data form. Now let me open an existing MAUI application. Here, I have already configured the Syncfusion MAUI data form control to show the contact details. In this example, I have already created a contact info class to store contact details, as well as a view model to manage and interact with these contact details within a data form. If you want to learn how to add the .NET MAUI data form control to your MAUI application, watch the video linked in the YouTube card above or in the description below. Now I run the application. You can see that the data form is rendered based on the provided data and the default layout time. Next, I'll show you how to enable floating label layout. To do that, let me set the layout type property to text input layout. Look, now the fields in the data form have changed to the floating label layout. Here, the container for each field is displayed in outline format. To customize the individual input fields, I'll start by defining a generate data form item event. Once that's done, I navigate to the event handler method. In this method, first check the current form item is not null. After that, verify whether its field name is first name. If these conditions are true, let me create an instance of text input layout settings and set the container type property to filled. As you can see in the first field, the background of the text input has been filled. In addition to the outlined and filled types, there is another option. None applies no border or background to the text input field. Next, I'll demonstrate how to display icons on the left and right sides of the input field. To display icon at the left of the text input, let me start by setting the show leading view property to true. Then, I create a label instance and assign it to the leading view property. In this label, specify the text property to F, which represents the icon. After that, I set the font family value to input layout icons, which contains custom fonts designed to display icons. This font family file is already stored in the resources folder. Then I'll customize the icon by specifying the text color, font size, height, and vertical text alignment. Now I run the application. You can see the icon has been displayed at the left of the text input. Similarly, to display the icon at the right of the text input, I create a condition to check if the field name is contact number. Within this condition, I'll set the show trailing view property to true to display the icon. Next, create a label instance and customize the icon, just as you did for the leading view. Once loaded, you can see an icon displayed on the contact number field's right. In order to display the icon within the input field, I'll set the trailing view position property to inside. Now the icon is displayed within the input field. Next, I'll demonstrate how to show or hide the characters in the password field. First, I go to the Contact Info class. Here, I'll set the attribute to define the data type as a password field. Next, I move to the Event Handler method. Then, I'll check whether the field name is password and ensure the type is DataForm password item. Within this condition, let me set the Enable Password Visibility toggle to true. You can see a toggle icon appears in the password field. Clicking this icon will display the characters that have been entered. Next, I'll move on to demonstrate how to provide hints for users when filling out the input field. In this case, the field name serves as a hint. To modify it, I will set the labeled text to name. This text will appear inside the input field when it is empty, acting as a hint label. To display content below the input field, I specify a placeholder text property, which serves as the helper text. You can see that the hint label and helper text are displayed in the first field. Next, to display the helper text within the input field, I'll set the Show Helper Text property to false. You can see the helper text is displayed within the input field. Finally, I'll demonstrate how to customize the appearance of the input field. To begin with, I'll create an instance of text input layout settings. Then let me add the corner radius for the border surrounding the password input field to 10, which provides a subtle rounding effect for the corners. After that, I specify a color for the border when the password field is not in focus, and set a different color for when it is focused. Lastly, set appropriate values to focus stroke thickness and in focus stroke thickness to control the border thickness in both the focused and in focus states. Now I run the application. You can notice that the customizations have been applied to the password field in both its focused and in focus states. Let's wrap up this video. You learned how to enable the floating label layout in the Syncfusion .NET MAUI DataForm control. You also saw how to add icons at the beginning and end of the label, display helper text that provide information for filling out the input field, and customize the appearance of the data form. If you want to see the working code of this example, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also included a link to check if you qualify for our community license, which gives you a free license key for our entire .NET MAUI controls. If you found this video helpful, click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.